we're looking for a new movement, and we're looking for new leaders. But maybe this California baby could grow up to be our next leader, but only with the right education.
Where does education begin?
I believe education begins in the home, with the parents. Just you learn a lot through your own experiences and through your family, just being around other people. And I personally feel that that's the groundwork of where everything begins for me.
I would definitely agree
for African Americans. Learning begins at home.
Yeah, that's an interesting question. I mean, it's sort of a whole bunch of psychological studies on that, I'm sure, sociological as well, educational studies on that. I think, if I may rephrase the question or restructure the question a little bit, for me, that's what's interesting to me is where education happens. Mm-hmm. Much more than where it begins, because for me education happens in many areas, not just in the formal sense that we go to classroom, we sit around a table and we do certain things that sound as education, but I think education happens everywhere. It happens when we turn on TV, what happens when we enter a public park. Mm-hmm. We get a sense of what it means to be a member of that certain community, of that certain region, of that certain nation, just by the way things are arranged, by things, how people interact with one another. That in itself is much, much more powerful in some sense than formal education, because most people, that's more access people have to quote unquote education than in the formal sense. Mm-hmm. So in that sense, studies or reflections on our world, our built environment, as well as our sort of symbolic environment, suggests that there's still very much an unequal, in some ways very unjust society. All you have to do is take and drive down, you know, South Central LA and drive down to Beverly Hills, and we can see the justice of our society. That's an education in itself. Mm-hmm. You don't have to ever step in a classroom.
Right.
See that.
So you say we probably would never have to step into a classroom to receive education.
For me, is the education is not, doesn't mean just in the formal sense that we take geography or astronomy, but mm-hmm. rather education is something that it happens all around us.
Right.
Not just in the interactions that we have, or for example, your mother teaches you about how to be a certain person, but also happens in when you go to walk around your neighborhood. You see how your neighborhood sees itself, how others sees itself, in terms of, for example, the federal government or the state government or the local governments perceive you as a citizen in terms of what the resources you have available to you. If you go around your neighborhood and you have to go to the nearest hospital, you have to take almost a 12-hour bus ride, that suggests certain things about how your government, how your representatives see you mm-hmm. in terms of the access or the resources that they
We have security at my school, obviously, and they all have walkie-talkies. And I was in a senior assembly one day, and the senior assembly was out, and I was going to one of my AP classes because I was going to go there and was able to gym. I was going to go do some extra study because I had been, that class was challenging for me. And on the way, one of the security guards, he stopped me and he said, what are you doing? Where are you going? And I told him I'm going to one of my AP classes. And he said, well, I just got something over my walkie-talkie. You fit the profile. People were running through the halls making noise and whatnot, you're going to detention. It was based at my school.
Wow.
And it was the first time I had ever been to detention. And honestly, the detention was like prison. Like, totally like.
There's the guard.
Everybody was just, they were standing around, like, there are no walls or anything, yeah. No windows or anything like that. And you had to stand there the whole time. And it was the biggest waste of time I've ever experienced in my life. And I was, like, mad about it. The track coach happened to be sitting in detention at that point, so I told him the story, and he allowed me to get a phone call. I won phone call for freedom. It was actually, like, a really good experience. But, like, but